This is a CJAS podcast and I'm John Luigi Zaza, Associate Professor of Nephrology at the Renal Unit, University of Verona, Italy. It's my pleasure to present on behalf of my co-authors our new publication in the journal entitled Proteomic Analysis of Urinary Macrovesicles and Exosomes in Medullary Sponge Kidney Disease and Autosomal Dominant Polycystic Kidney Disease. Medullary sponge kidney disease is a rare kidney malformation, future nephrocalcinosis, and recurrent kidney stones. Our aim was to identify new pathophysiological features of medullary sponge kidney disease and to find diagnostic biomarkers that can be used to distinguish from other cystic disorders, particularly during early stage before clinical signs of kidney dysfunction. To achieve this, we decided to look to the proteome of urinary extracellular vesicles. These membrane-enclosed particles are released from cells into the urine under both normal and pathological conditions. The content of this vesicle can be transferred to target cell, where they act as extraordinary mediators in kidney pathophysiology. The key to our study was the comparison of proteins isolated from urinary microvesicle and exosome of 15 patients with medullary sponge kidney disease and another 15 with autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease. All 30 patients had normal kidney function. We identified the proteins by mass spectrometry and compared their abundance in the urinary microvesicle and exosome of patients with each disease. The profiles were distinct with the 34 proteins acting as discriminatory biomarkers. Most of the proteins upregulated in urinary extracellular vesicles from autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease patients are known to be involved in epithelial cell differentiation, kidney development, cell migration, and extracellular matrix organization. All these mechanisms are essential from the progressive enlargement of tubular cysts and adaptive change in the kidney tissue. The most strongly upregulated protein in the group was prominin, also known as CD133, a transmembrane glycoprotein often expressed on adult stem cells and kidney progenitor cells, reflecting attempts by these renal cells to adjust to the aberrant proliferation rate. In contrast, a few proteins were upregulated in medullary sponge kidney disease patients, and most of these were found in the microvesicles. One example was osteopontin, which is thought to derive mineralization associated with kidney stones and bone mineralization defects. This could help us to understand the biological basis of nephrocalcinosis and kidney stone formation in medullary sponge kidney disease. Our study applied the proteomics to the analysis of extracellular vesicles to provide insight into the pathogenesis of the two kidney diseases. Early diagnosis would also reduce the need for expensive and invasive clinical tests, and more important, it would mean the clinician could start preventative to avoid disease progression.
This podcast is copyrighted by the American Society of Nephrology, all rights reserved. All content in this podcast is for informational purposes only and is not intended to be medical advice. This podcast should not be used in a medical emergency or for the diagnosis or treatment of any medical condition. Please consult your doctor or other qualified healthcare provider if you have any questions about any medical condition or before taking any drug, changing your diet, or commencing or discontinuing any course of treatment. Thank you for listening to this podcast of the American Society of Nephrology.